in terms of the strapline of challenge, ambition and opportunity, there's a number of things I think relevant to us. Just a little snapshot initially on the sector. So as of, you know, a report published by the Independent Craft Brewers of Ireland and Bord Bia about a month ago, we have about 100 breweries in Ireland now, craft breweries. 70 of those are production breweries and the other 30 contract in those facilities. And we're at a stage where we have about 2.5% of the total beer output in Ireland. So it's still a small sector, but growing rapidly and vibrant. About 500 people employed directly and some knock-on employment as well as that. But I suppose it is a small sector. I would say it's still fledgling, but it's brought kind of vibrancy and innovation to the beer sector. Which I think is all welcome. Like I say, it's brought employment. It's spread all over the country. 25 out of 26 counties have a brewery. So it's made up of people that are entrepreneurial, very ambitious, and I do think there's a lot of opportunities out there for the sector. But I suppose there are challenges ahead. Like I said, it's a small sector still in what's a highly regulated space, and that sometimes creates challenges for small companies. And it still has a small, I suppose, platform domestically in order to support the export side. Personally, I see good opportunities going forward in both domestic and export. I think, you know, what can, and there has been a lot of support, I should acknowledge, for the sector, you know, through Department of Ag in particular, that's helped us get this far. I suppose going forward, you know, two things on the horizon, which are, you know, one positive, one negative. There's a craft beer bill going through the process at the moment, which would allow small breweries to serve from their own premises. I think that could be a bit of a game changer for some breweries if they're in the right location, assuming that it's not overly restricted.
The wild brewery trail.
Yeah. Well, look, it's partly for the small business to be able to get revenue, you know, at its own premises. It's a potential tourist product. Yeah. Like I say, it is a trail. I suppose the other thing, you know, coming down the tracks at the moment is the public health alcohol bill. You know, I suppose I've seen craft beer has been part of the solution in terms of, you know, how people in Ireland approach alcohol. You know, we're now talking about flavour, providence, you know, a whole new dimension. I think we need to be careful as well that there's no sort of unintended consequences, you know, that would potentially trip up the sector that's enjoyed lots of support so far and I think has a lot to add going forward.
All right. That's an example of innovation, isn't it, Aidan?
Yeah, and in fact, I'm delighted that we're hearing from people like Seamus and Caroline and so on, because people tend to think just of the beef and the dairy, the big behemoths in the room. But in fact, if you're looking at innovation in the sector, and of course, there's great innovation in dairy and beef, I don't mean, but there is fantastic work being done by smaller companies in prepared consumer foods, the craft brewers, the small distillers, the horticulture sector, the seafood sector. Companies of smaller size occupying niches, but very, very agile, very, very innovative, and doing fantastic work. And the growth of the craft brewing sector and the smaller distilling sector has just been an outstanding success. Now, it's part of a global tide of change in the drinks industry. But the Irish companies are doing really, really well as part of that. And I'm glad to hear Seamus acknowledge that the department, I think, does do its bit to support that. And I can say to Seamus, I do an awful lot to support his company personally every weekend. But as I'm sure many here do. But these companies ultimately are the ones where we can grow in particular employment. And employment often in quite isolated parts of the country, scattered around the country, because they tend to be more labour intensive than the big dairy and meat companies. And so they are a very important part of the future for us. They also provide, one of the big issues we work on now in the department, we have always had about half of our staff working on food safety and animal health. A lot of people don't understand that we're so committed on the food safety side. But the other big issue that's coming along now is things like food authenticity and so on. And people's understanding of where their food comes from and what it is and who produces it and so on. And these smaller companies can tell very strong stories in that regard. They have a great marketing platform. And they actually, their existence and the stories they tell play to the benefit of the entire sector, mm-hmm. Which is really important.